Mooncoal has built a working trebuchet in Lego Fortnite. This is version 1. Wait until you see version 3. In version 1, thrusters on the counterweight were required to reset the trebuchet. From here, gravity takes care of the rest. Version 2 is a lot smoother and can actually fire projectiles. Better still, it resets itself using gravity, no thrusters required. To add the payload, Mooncoal is using a thin floor piece. Breaking the floor piece will cause the two foundation blocks to drop into the trebuchet. Firing foundations is one thing, but what about players? Sleep in the bed, then activate the switch to launch yourself. Hi, my name is Dom and welcome back to Top Gaming Plays. Don't forget to drop a like if you enjoyed today's video and submit your clips using the link in the description. But let's get into it. Luxar has built something very special at the highest point of his village. Just imagine the views. This is the most creative monorail design we've seen yet. Four-line clear's design can turn sharp corners, ascend and descend. The hook design means there's a gap for the higher railing to fit into it. That means it can essentially climb. The thruster means that miraculously, it always points forward. To ride on it, you might want to get some fences or something to keep you strapped in. Monorails are great when they don't break, but they have one major downside. They can't turn. Digipal found a fix. And he's not the only one. This player has taken a slightly clunkier approach, but it's good proof of concept. There's just enough gap between the wheels and the track to allow for gradual bends. It can even go up or down. So if you're looking to get flexwood early in the game, here's a neat trick. Place TNT or a boom barrel next to the cactus and blow it up. Thomas has an even smarter trick. Why waste your own TNT? Just aggro and kite some of these dynamite-wielding enemies and have them waste their TNT. and it's time for Village of the Day. Blindboard Ape is showing us around his village called Brick Block Bluffs. It starts strong with one of the most creative village entrances we've seen. A geyser can help you get to the village, but for this demonstration, we'll take the stairs. Blindboard Ape isn't much of a fan of the prefabs, it seems, which makes this way more impressive. The two-story tavern is my favourite of the builds. I like how the multiple entrances work into the landscape. If you're looking for a low material way to travel long distances, or you're sick of your monorail or flying craft breaking, you might want to try Moshi's creation. Use the four thrusters to lift the platform to a high point. At the desired height, jump and glide off. The platform is heavier than the balloons can hold up, so it'll gradually float back to the ground. Wheels on the bottom will ensure it will bounce, not break. To travel long distances, you could create a chain of these in the direction you wish to travel. That would allow you to get to and from your POIs pretty quickly. At least one of us around here is working. Fun's airship design claims to be one of the most reliable yet. They're about to turn on the thrusters and get that awful braking sound. Listen. Yet, the ship remains intact. It's turnable, but can only turn in one direction. The design uses a dynamic foundation locked into place by fences to allow for separated thrusters. To land, simply add weight to the build. Just try not to crash. High Flyers was transporting three chests of bright core and copper to another village when disaster struck. Two chests completely destroyed. Ouch. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to hit subscribe if you're new, and we'll see you tomorrow for another video.